everybody, and welcome to our second show for Shattering Barriers. This is Will Briere, and we have two very special guests with us today. Ron Lastman, the chair of the Low Commission on Disabilities, and Alginado Lewis, who's going to be talking about himself and the hockey league that he's involved with. Lewis, how are you today?
Good, I'm good. Good. I'm fine.
Can you tell me a little bit about yourself, your personal history, how you grew up, and just, you know, your life? And
I came to this country and back in 73. I was 11 years old, and I lived in Cambridge, Massachusetts. I went to Cambridge High School, Cambridge Ranch in Latin, and Lowell. And then I came to Methuen. I lived in Methuen for 23 years now.
Okay.
And
excellent.
And then that's where I've been.
How did you become disabled?
I fell off a ladder doing construction. It's going to be 23 years of March of next year.
Okay.
And I became handicapped, disabled.
How did you deal with some of this stuff?
I dealt okay. I didn't have a really bad down on it. I just took it as it is and continue on with my life.
You got through it, right?
Right.
So you had a lot of good supports.
Right. Family support, friends, and stuff like that.
Right. Let's talk a little bit about the hockey. How did you get involved with that?
After my injury, I got involved with Northeast Passage up in New Hampshire, and I'd done different sports with them, and water ski, and all kinds of stuff.
You've actually brought some of your equipment with you.
Mm-hmm.
Can you maybe describe and explain what it is?
Okay, this is the... This is one of the old sleds. Okay, this is one of the old sleds they start off with. And it's pretty old, but I still use it because I like it. And I do have a new one. It's better than this, but I don't like it, so I use the old one.
So that's a brand new one. So you have a couple different ones that
right.
you can use.
Right.
And anybody can play in this league,
right.
correct?
Anybody can play.
Okay. And
now those are regular skate blades, right? They're just mounted onto the chair.
Right.
On the bottom of the
right.
chair.
Right. The first sleds came out like this, and now they have fancy sleds. They make their own blades for it. Some goalie sleds, they have the plastic blades. Because it will slide better, you know,
yeah.
side to side. But I stick with my old one because I just like it.
It's like a, you know, an old pair of shoes. You
right.
know, you want to keep wearing it. You're comfortable.
Right. Right.
You know.
I'm comfortable with it. Yeah.
It's like like a drummer who has his own drum kit. He wants to. He doesn't want to play somebody else's kit. He has something
right.
that he plays and
right.
he's comfortable with. Just as an analogy, I think we actually have some video also that we can show.
Right, I'm not playing here, but this is basically the speed of the game. Regular hockey, regular rules, same size goal.
And the rank is
yeah,
the
right here.
Goal.
There's a save right here. That's me right there.
Is Louis making a save?
Yeah, right there. They hit me right in the head with that one.
Wow.
Yeah.
This is great stuff.
I think we won this game, too.
So how did you guys actually meet? Can we go into that a little bit?
Well, I met Louis when I went to join into hockey. I saw it on Chronicle one night, and I went to check it out. And they said, you can't just come here and watch. You got to get on the sled. So I got on the sled, and that was it.
So it was like trial by fire. Ron Lastman, he's in there.
Right.
And I have no clue what I'm doing, but we're trying it. And, you know, that's life, you know.
And I realized I couldn't skate that good. So I said, I'll be in the goal, because I played goal as a kid, you know, in the neighborhood. So that's what I did.
Yeah, Ronnie was the goalie, and then I became the goalie after he left.
So, I mean, it's regular, you know, regulation.
Full check. Everything. It's wild.
We have penalties and everything. We have everything.
Well, fights, we try not to because we'll try to be friends as
Yeah, but it happens, right? It's competition.
Once in a while, there's a punch here and there.
Another save by Louis.
We had anybody that pulls the shirt over the head.
Oh, there's another save by Louis.
Louis.
And the first time we went to Canada back in '95.
Yeah, that's how we used to have to go.
We travel a lot.
To play with, so we had to go to Canada and do tournaments.
Wow. Tournaments
and all year long.
Everywhere.
Just to go to Canada for one weekend.
We go to Utah. We travel almost all over the country.
That's not when I was playing.
Well, when you were playing, we went to Canada most of the time, and around Massachusetts and New York. But now it's we go everywhere. We've been in Dallas. We've been Colorado and Utah. You name it.
And I think you said this league is sponsored by UNH.
Yes, UNH is. It's involved with this. We play for UNH.
And it's still going on today?
Yes, but the Northeast Passage is the program that started this.
And that's in Durham?
That's in Durham. It's right inside the UNH.
So if that's anybody wants to learn how to play, I'll start playing, they can contact Northeast Passage?
They can contact Northeast Passage. They can contact the coach. They can contact Jill. Jill is from Northeast Passage, too.
Now, I assume, like with any sport, there's training and costs that are involved with this, right?
There's training and there's practice once a week. Once a week there's practice and cost. You buy your own sled, you buy your own sticks, and you buy your own helmets and your own equipment.
How about health insurance?
Health insurance, you have to register it with the USA Hockey Registrar. You have to register with them just in case something happens, and you are registered with them.
Hey, Ron, now you've been involved with this hockey league over the years. Can you tell me a little bit about how you've been involved and what your role is? And I see the stick in front of me, and maybe a little bit about that.
Sure. That's Louis's goalie stick, but I played with Louis, I don't know, 15 years ago now.
Yeah.
And I was a goalie. I saw it on Chronicle. I went down one night to watch it, and they said, "You can't watch. You got to get right on the sled and try it out. You won't know what it means until you get on the sled." So I did, and the following week I was on the team. So it was pretty good, and that's how Louis and I met.
So was it like a love at first sled?
Oh, sure. Yeah. to be able to play. To play a sport is pretty cool because I never had an interaction with the locker room and all that stuff. It's quite a thing at 34 years old to start playing sports.
Yeah, sure. So there's that certain level of energy and adrenaline rush that you, I'm sure, get. How fast are these things?
Some of the guys can get pretty fast. Yeah. Pretty fast, but it's a slower paced game, of course. But it's still exciting. Because it's full body contact and they slam you into the boards, and it's kind of fun.
Yeah. Tell them about Joey. Joe Howard.
Joe Howard, yeah. He's an Olympian. He was our best player, WLMPT. And yeah. he could do one end of the ice and the other in 60 seconds. So he was very fast.
Really?
Here's some of the old equipment I used to use. I think they've changed now, but you can see there's industrial hacksaw blades on the end of these sticks, and that's what you use to propel yourself across the ice. You stick them in.
That'll give you traction across the ice.
You stick them in and into the ice, and that's how you propel yourself. You hold your sticks.
Now,
like,
this is Boston. Are these Boston blades?
Yeah, that's where Louis and I first met, playing for the Boston blades. Louis, you might want to show them how you propel yourself around.
Yeah, if we could maybe, can we get it? Is there any way we could do a demonstration?
Yeah, you just grab the sticks like this, because there's a left and a right, and you cannot switch. You cannot switch the right to the left because you won't be able to push yourself right. So you have to make sure your blades are in towards you, and you cannot go like this. It has to be like this. And grab them from the top and just push right on the ice. Just dig this into the ice and just push. And that's how you move around and then hit the puck when the puck comes to you and score a goal.
You might want to show off your goalie stick here, Louis.
There we go.
This is the same way as that, but we only use one stick. And the other one is the catching glove. The catching glove has some picks on it, too, so you can kind of push ourselves on it. At the bottom here has a pick, ice pick, so you can push yourself on it, too. And the bottom here has an ice pick, too. And you always have to keep the stick like this part in because you're saving like this. So you have to keep this part in when you push yourself around the goalie.
All right, guys. Thanks for taking some time and coming in on and sharing your story with us on Shattering Barriers. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Ron?
You're welcome, Will.
Thank you.
Louis, good to see you again.
And good to see you, too.
Take care.